Good morning. Welcome to our podcast, The Good Music. Today we are going to talk about the 70s music of Spain.
And we are visited by a music historian called Isabella. So, good morning, Isabella. How are you?
Good morning, everyone. I'm excited to be with here today. Thank you.
You are welcome. We're excited to talk to you too, because today we're going to talk about some artists from the 70s.
Like Nino Bravo from the Melodic Songs, New from the Urban Rock, and Medina Zahara from the Andalusian Rock.
Oh, I really like these artists. An interesting fact, do you know that in Spain in the 70s, a lot of flamenco music was listened to?
Yes, and Camarón was a very famous artist in this type of music. One example is Every Time We Look at Each Other. Do you know this song, Isabella?
Yes, I love that song. It is very representative of new flamenco.
What other songs do you like, Isabella?
For example, in Melodic Song, I know the song A Kiss and a Flower by Nino Bravo.
Al partir, un beso y una flor, un te quiero, una caricia y un adiós.
I think I know this song. Do you know any urban rock songs?
Right now, I don't know. Do you know any?
Yes. For example, All Hymns for New Warriors by New.
Thank you very much, Isabella, for being here and joining us today.
Thank you. I had a good time with you.
And last but not least, from the artistic movement Andalusian Rock, we have a piece of the song I Need to Breathe by Medina Zahara. And we will see you in another podcast.
Hi everyone, welcome to Los 90 Principales. Today we have a Spanish music band that is a total hit at the moment. Mecano!
Hi Charlotte, thank you for inviting us to your podcast.
We are really thankful for this opportunity.
Thank you very much, we are very excited to be here.
So let's start the interview. How did you start in the music industry?
Everything starts when I asked my brother and my girlfriend to go with me to one of my concerts.
In that concert, we met the producer Miguel Ángel Arenas and he asked us to make a music group.
And after that, we composed our first song called Hoy No Me Puedo Levantar.
Okay, let's listen to it. Oh my god, it's fantastic, I love it.
I agree with you, but I'm a little bit bored of listening to this song too much.
You're really honest saying that. And guys, what is your favorite song that you have composed?
If I'm honest, our best song, which is also my favorite, is Hijo de la Luna.
Que pretendes hacer con
My favorite one is Un Año Más, because it talks about the New Year's Eve.
My favorite song is Me Colé en una Fiesta because I love the rhythm and I love parties.
I agree with you, Anna. That song is incredible. So we have arrived at the end of this podcast. I hope you have enjoyed it and see you in the next program.
Talking about Spanish music in the 1980s, we should include La Movida Madrileña, the colorful but brief punk movement that erupted in the years immediately after General Francisco Franco's death. Luis Díaz Ronda, a promoter, writer and curator of La Ola Interior, Spanish Ambient and Acid Exoticism, claims that the transition to democracy and punk coincided in time a bit. There was a synergy there somehow. However, La Movida is so dominant that it frequently overshadows other daring Spanish songs from the era.
This is partly the reason why, in 2018, Díaz Ronda put together La Contraola, synthwave and post-funk from Spain, 1980 to 1986, for the Les Disques Bongo Joe label. The compilation included a number of post-funk, synthwave and industrial bands that were operating in reaction to La Movida, according to Díaz Ronda.
With an additional perspective of the nation's underground music scene, La Ola Interior highlights musicians who were looking elsewhere in time, seeking out different traditions rather than focusing on resistance.
Notable regional labels such as Music from Memory and Emotional Rescue, along with Spanish labels like Abstracte, Discos de Género, Pasa Continuo, and Equilibrio, are also striving to highlight alternative portrayals of Spain in 1980s. Avant-garde musician in Madrid, hi-pitch experimenting with foreign instruments they were unable to play, had made cassette traveling the nation via mail, and put industrial música cósmica along the Mediterranean coast.
Porque mi niñez sigue jugando en tu playa, pues contigo.
When combined, these images show that although operating at a disadvantage relative to their neighbors and losing exposure in their own area, the experimental Spanish micro scenes in the 1980s were every bit as colorful as those across the rest of Europe.
In reality, the songs that are pleasant are moises wasn't that various from what was being made in different urban nations. Mention Antoni Turbe, a Spain song that are pleasant are moises journalist. Spain was a country that had just arisen from an autocracy accompanying a most of cultural required to be distinguished to other neighbors, accompanied in very little knowledge of lyrical experience.
And this is the end of our course, but we hope you enjoyed it as much as we did, and see you next time.